Yo, what's going on, people? There's this movie on Netflix that came out a couple weeks ago called The Perfection. It stars Allison Williams from Girls and from Get Out, and Logan Browning. And I haven't really seen her in many things before, but I thought she was great here. And man, this movie was exactly my type of weird. I saw the trailer, and to me, honestly, Netflix's their trailers can sometimes ruin it. They can make or break the movie, but I thought it was brilliant here. It really, if you watch a trailer, it really kind of led me to believe that it would be a different type of movie, like this weird viral, some sort of disease viral breakout thing. And it did not go there at all. I'm not really going to go into spoilers because I think it was a really good movie. I think it was really interesting. I think it deserves, it deserves some attention. People should watch it because it's just not what you think it would be. But man, I really did enjoy it. And there were some certain things, and I'm going to go over a little bit of it, but there's some certain things that I really enjoyed that I want to kind of go over here. Just what really stood out to me. The first was, I mean, it's going to seem really like stereotypical, but just like when the movie first starts, you see Allison Williams, she's a little weird and she's going through her shit. And then she meets up with Logan Browning's character. I think her name was Lizzie. I can't remember. Anyway, they meet up and you can tell almost right away that there's some attraction between them. And it's so like it starts off very subtle and then it builds up over the course of the next like 5, 10 minutes from that beginning part of the movie. You can feel and see little things going on that they're starting, they're attracted to one another. And then there was this one specific scene that really flipped the script for me, and it turned it into this kind of the sexual tension is just there, and it shows it in this next clip here. So you see what happens there. After a while, they eventually hook up, and I'm not gonna go into everything. They hook up, and then she get they Logan Browning's character decides she wants to fucking backpack through China or something like that, and things get very, very weird, and then they get weirder and weirder and weirder. But she gets very sick, and it's like, what in the actual fuck is going on here? And then it makes you think, this is what they showed in the trailer that makes you think it's some weird, virus infection breakout sort of thing. And it's just not that type of movie. I can't explain it to you any better, and I don't want to spoil it. It's just not that type of movie. One thing leads to another. And it was just very well done. I really enjoyed it. Again, the attraction between the two characters, I think it hits off very well. And I like that. This is what I love about Netflix, because movies like this, I don't know how well they do in the theater. Those smaller mid-range kind of movies aren't really a thing in the theater now. It's either documentaries or these small indie movies or these big, huge, blockbusters with Avengers and all this other stuff. And a lot of the in-between stuff is getting eaten away at by the internet, Netflix, Hulu, HBO, all these streaming services. So, again, I've for a long time believed that movies can be as good as the situation in which you see them, and I was at home, I think it was like a Saturday night or something, and I had saw the trailer for it and I was like, you know what, let me watch this because I thought it was interesting and I really, really enjoyed it. So I'm really happy to see movies like this do well, but please do yourself a favor, watch this movie. And if you liked it, say something in the comments. If you didn't like it, also say something in the comments. But anyway, thanks for watching this video, guys. I appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.